Okay. I'm going to email your username and password, but your username right now is JMULDOOM, and I'll email your password
Okay.
right after the call so you can log in. But it's just basically enter username and password. You can change your password anytime, which we'll go through. The first thing that you need to do is you need to go up here to My Profile when you log in and change this. Now, this is where you might want to. We've got two sections, one section for the Marketing and Training Center and one section for the e-letters and e-campaigns. This is where you
Okay.
need to enter in your information, whether it be both of your information, whether it be just your information. This information is what you need to put in that will actually go to the marketing materials.
Okay.
At the same time, when you enter all this information in, if you go to the very bottom and you can change your password anytime, like I say, but this is where you need to enter in your zip codes and your cities of your territory so I can enter in those email addresses that I have for
Perfect.
those areas. And then
Got it.
when I upload those, I'm going to put them in a group called Suspects, so you'll have them in an identified group that you could do emails to.
Perfect.
I did get all your information, all your contacts in, and I did put them into groups. So as we go through this in the contact section, you'll see that.
Okay.
First thing is we go to contacts. Once you get your e-letters and your kind of your standard documents, your standard letters going, you're going to be able to do a lot just from this address book that I'll share with you. First of all, you can look up any of your groups.
Oh,
For
great.
example, the REO email database. If I just click on search, then I scroll to the bottom and I've got 89 people in the REO agent database. If I
Perfect.
go to the, what are the other ones? Reverse mortgage database. So I put them in groups. The database of agents that you have, I put them in the agent group.
Perfect, and then lender under lender.
Exactly.
Great.
Lenders. Now I may have put them in. Yeah, I put them in the lenders group, plural. Because there's also a group called lender, and I didn't want to disturb that one. So lender is probably zero, but lenders is your database.
Okay,
So
got it.
agent is the agent database you gave me. So yeah, so they're all
Great.
there. So if I go and say I want to search for everything, well, first of all, let me do this. Since I'm in the agent database, if I wanted to say I wanted to email something out to these 1,900 people, I literally could go over here and assign an action and assign these people to a 1,900, right, to an e-campaign if I wanted to. At some point in time, what I would recommend you do is once you do a couple of these letters, and I'll show you how to do that today, you're going to want to send out kind of a, I don't know, a get back, a get acquainted email to all these people just to see how many bounce back in terms of
Okay.
their good or bad email addresses.
Perfect.
You have the ability of creating any groups that you want. So the group catalog at the bottom, as well as in the contacts, will let you create groups. So you can create a company group, you can create, an A group, a B group, C client group, that type of thing.
Okay.
When you go down to import contacts, that is the tool that I use to bring your contacts in. But you'll notice on the right-hand side is a synchronization feature. If you want to download this sync desktop application, and if you wanted to sync your contacts that are in TitleRepSolutions with your Microsoft Outlook, you can do that, and you can synchronize even the calendar items in Microsoft Outlook. So if you have contacts in this database that aren't in Outlook, it will go to Outlook and vice versa. So it doesn't disrupt any kind of synchronization that you're doing with a handheld personal device like an iPhone, something like that.
Or my BlackBerry or something like that.
Exactly. It won't interfere with that at all. But if you put a contact in your BlackBerry that went to Outlook, then we'll pick it up from Outlook. So it can save yourself some time. So right now you have 2,650 people in the system. If you ever want to export out the contacts and just take them back out, you can just click on Export Contacts and it puts them in the same Outlook format that you can have them back. So it's easy to get them in, it's easy to get them out.
Got it.
When you click on Add Contact, to put a brand new person in. I'm just going to add Roger. He's in the website end of the business. But I'm just going to do this for an example. If you put a contact in, you know, you can start typing away address, city, state, zip, phone numbers, that type of thing. But what I recommend you do is I recommend you go over here to attach office and look to see if you have that contact in with an office already. They may or may not be there. I'm just going to say use this company, use TitleRepSolutions. It just saves you time. So you don't have to enter in the address in every single time you add a contact.
Oh, that's great.
Same thing with groups. Now, if you select them as an agent, they'll be there and available to you to select for putting orders in the system and tracking your orders. If you select them as an office, escrow office, or escrow officer, they'll be there again when you want to select an escrow officer from your sourcing system, which I'll show you. But put them in as many groups as you want, and then you can do emails accordingly to them.
Great.
When you save your contact, we try to save you some time. Number one, we'll say, do you want to launch the holiday campaign? Do you want to launch the birthday campaign? If you put in a birthday, it actually will ask you, do you want to launch that birthday campaign too? I'm just going to say yes to this. And then if I want to add another one, I'm just powering through adding a bunch of people, it's just add contact. Duplicate contact means if I have 10 business cards from one real estate office, I want to put them in all one at a time, but have the same company, same address, city, state, zip. That's duplicate contact. Finish just lets me go right back to the contact or to the address book in general. I'm just going to go back to this contact just to show you what I did. First of all, when you email out, let's say, these 2,500 emails and even more on the suspect side, if you get people going to the bottom of the email and clicking on please remove me, we'll manage that for you and we'll check this box, we'll highlight them in red, and we'll actually put a note in the note field that says they've been removed. So, and then you'll be notified that they've been removed. So,
okay.
If someone says please remove me, you'll be notified. You can always go in and uncheck the box and override it for the next email, but just know that they've been asked to be removed and you can put them back on if you want. If the email bounces or is undeliverable, that's when you're going to want to go in and clean up the database yourself. All emails come from you, your name, whatever email address you put into on the My Profile section. So it comes from you and your name rather than us at TitleRepSolutions. So it just that's one of the benefits too. You don't have to worry about it not knowing who they get it from. They're going to get it from you.
Clicking
on assigned campaigns. Assigned campaigns just show you the campaigns that have been implemented for this person. Since I started the holiday campaign, I can go look at the Happy Memorial Day, let's say, and see what that card is. I'm going to show you how you can change and edit these. The photo and all this contact information comes from another source, which I'll show you how to configure. But it just lets you see kind of a preview of what those items are. If you ever wanted to add another campaign for this person immediately, so let's say not only did I add them to my database to launch the holiday campaign, but I want them to get, it was a nice to meet you kind of email. I could always go up here and click on add and add that kind of campaign. It was nice to meet you kind of campaign, or what is title insurance? You can add as many campaigns as you want right from that screen without having to go anything further.
Okay.
If one thing too is when your client gets an e-card from us, it will be different every year. So Happy St. Patrick's Day will be different than this Happy St. Patrick's Day. You don't have to worry about that, and it will go on until you go over here and click on this delete box to delete it.
Okay.
Document library happens to be a place where you can upload documents for this one particular contact. If you have things you want to hold on to, whether it be a photo of the person, whether it be anything, it's just a place for you to put electronic photos, images, PDFs, anything that you want in his file folder. That's what that's for.
Okay.
Campaign history just shows you what has gone out in the past, what emails, what campaigns have occurred in the past for that particular contact. Tasks are those things that you want to add for this contact that are associated with a calendar. So if you wanted to put down a little comment, make sure you call Roger 30 days from now, then it would appear in the calendar, it would appear in Roger's record, and it would eventually sync to your Outlook if you synchronize. Expenses, that doesn't exist in California with SB 133, but in other areas it does. So we're working on an expense tracking solution for people, especially in Washington, where they're allowed to spend up to $100 per agent per year. And then order history, once you have a chance to put in all your orders and start looking at that, then you can actually look up orders by the individual person and drill down on the details of every order. And I'll show you how that works at the very end.
Okay.
So contacts are really pretty simple in terms of when you log in, first step is you're going to go update your My Profile. Second thing is when you start looking at your contacts and drilling down on contacts, when you're in the address book, you can take some action from this address book. You know, obviously searching a simple way. If you want to search and find all the people for a specific company, you can. You know, that's all there. If you want to, you know, check a box down here and then click on, you know, delete a contact for whatever reason, or if you want to go over here into the right-hand side with a hammer and the wrench, you can, you know, just send a letter right out of the library or print a letter or delete a contact. You can take action over here on the right-hand side. That's contacts. Now, on the Marketing Center, if you want to send a marketing flyer, let's say you get a flyer from your marketing department and you want to send it out to one person or many people, first of all, I'm going to recommend you give me the flyer. If you send me the PDF or the JPEG of the flyer, then I will upload it for you rather than teach you how to use that admin control right now. But that's eventually we're going to get to the place where you can upload the documents and show you how that works. If you find a document you want or a flyer you want to send out and, you know, it's loaded, maybe you have the marketing piece of the month, then it'll have a logo in the upper left-hand corner. I'll fix that logo for you and then all your contact information at the bottom. I just didn't upload the logo. If you want to send it to one person, you can by typing it in. It doesn't have to be in the address book. You can type it into multiple people or you can go over your address book and send it from your address book as well.
Got it.
The training center. Training center is where you might want to get into videos down the road. If you want to do 30-second minute videos. I mean, I copied a couple of videos over just from the YouTube right now. So here's Twitter in plain English and here's online photo sharing. I mean, you literally can put any videos here that you want. These are thumbnails that you're seeing now, pictures of the rep or words. I put some kind of Matt Gagline examples in there for you to look at. But when you click on the video, it will launch a template that you have control over. So the client's going to see this. So you can say, okay, I want to send this video to somebody. Clients are going to see this. They'll see your logo. They'll see your thumbnail. And when you click on play to play the video, then it will play your template setup. It'll play your template setup with all the links here. So you know that, you know, I just need to get links in terms of where you want the client to be sent off to. But it's easy for a client to see, I don't know, your customer service person, your title officer, or any other explanation. This happens, you know, this video here happens to be just one that I posted. This online photo sharing, so here, blogs. If you want to know what blogs were, I got to fix that link. It just allows you to see other third-party videos, YouTube videos, as well as videos yourself. But it's so simple to record a video and upload a video that you might want to get into that down the road. Let's spend time on tips. Tips is where you can write your e-letters, use the campaigns that are already established in the system today. So the address
and all these are SB 133 compliant?
Just be careful about that. The property profiles, the farming, the what is title insurance are, you're going to find other things in the library as well as, you know, the property profiles, title insurance, that kind of thing. Just be careful.
And I can send myself a test message and get it approved?
Yes, and I'll show you how to do that in a second.
Okay, cool.
So when you look at marketing campaigns, here are all the default campaigns. So let's just go look at the – and D just stands for default. I played around with holiday cards, so it's not D anymore. But let's play around with holiday cards. The reason why we set it up for default and all that, if a county wanted to lock it down for content reasons, they could do that. You're not locked down, so you have flexibility. That's what I'm saying. Just be a little careful in terms of what you're doing. If I wanted to look at what's going on with Happy Memorial Day, for example, I can see the date and time that it's going to go out, but I can also go and edit and play off of this. So Anytime you see subject, that's what the client's going to see. So you can change the subject, wishing you a happy Memorial Day. So you can change the subject. Or you can change anything here you want, but just then that becomes your postcard. Then it becomes your e-card. It's not default, and it's not the same as everybody else has anymore. Submitting it always is like saving your work. After you save your work, if you want to click on a send test to see how it's going to look, you simply click on send test, and it will immediately send you an email. It'll immediately send an email out and show me exactly what it's going to look like. Okay, so you can test that and send that as many times as you want. It just popped up here in my email box, Live Messenger. Now, some helpful hints on this. I mean, obviously your photo will be up and the logo will be down at the bottom. But some helpful hints.
You'll be able to put that picture of Tim and I in there?
Yes, I did.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, when it comes out of the test, that's what we'll see.
I see.
When you are in the editing mode, a couple of helpful hints or tips. Number one, this upper left-hand button lets you get rid of all the header information up here so you see more of the screen to edit. So if I click there for full screen, I've just got more things, more easy ways of looking at this. We mail merge and we send everybody their own email. So we don't broadcast out in a blind carbon copy fashion. You can actually mail merge individual names and information within the email. So I can literally say, by clicking on tag and then clicking on first name, say first name, you know, happy Memorial Day. I can literally say, you know, within the body of the message, you know, first name, happy Memorial Day. So it can be personal.
A quick question on that. If I have just an email address and I don't have a first name, will it say first name?
No, it'll actually show nothing. It'll be a blank space.
Okay, cool.
Yep, it'll be a blank space.
Okay.
So just know that on the tags, anything that you put here can be merged into it. Everything that you see is ELE, that's your information. So that would be whatever you guys typed in on the configuration screen.
Got it.
Now, at the home screen, we clicked on My Profile. What I also want you to make a note of is when you're in this tips section, click on Personal Configuration at the top. Personal Configuration is where you put all of your information into. Now, I will upload, since I already have your photo and logo, I will upload your photo and logo for you. I'll do that right after the call. But just click on Personal Configuration and put in the information that you want. If you want to type it as, you know, whatever you type here is what it'll be used in the mail merge field. So if you want to, you know, like this, you can. Or you can even hard code, and I'll show you on the editing mode. You can type in anything you want. So just ignore everything that's not name, address, city, state, zip, phone number, because everything else is being used for our real estate version. We have a real estate version of this called Lead Marketer that we use. So just, you don't need to put zip codes here. Really, it's name, address, city, state, zip code when you go to this. So where I was saying that you don't necessarily have to use the personal configuration screen, if you're in the edit mode of this email, I'm going to show you down here, where I've got agent first, agent last, that's your information. Well, you don't have to, you know, do a mail merge. It just makes it easy. I mean, you could, you know, type it in too in any way that you want. You know what I mean? So
Right. You've
got free form, and then just make sure, don't send the test to yourself until you save it. So once you save it, then send the test, and then it's going to come back the way you look at it. If you don't want to have a fax number on it, just, you know, delete the fax number kind of thing.
Got it.
Now, another helpful thing that you can do is if you want to link out to anything, you can link out, you can refer out, you can, and you provide testimonials. You just can't sell, push, train yourself from an SB133. But if I wanted to say, click here to visit our title company website or my website, you know,
right,
for more information, instead of typing in www.fidelitysd.com, you literally can say, okay, I want to highlight, click here. I'm going to go up here to this hyperlink right next to this image, the landscape image. So if I click on hyperlink, I want people to say, okay, if they click on that word, literally click here, I want them to go to fidelitys.com. and I want them to see fidelity, title, and, whatever you want to put down as a title. So by me doing that, when the customer gets this email and they put their cursor on top of click here, that title will pop up. And if they click there, they'll actually go to the website. Nice. So you can insert, go visit my website. You can, instead of down here, agent website, you may want to just put it in some other website you link to. You can use this any way that you want in terms of referring out.
Great.
I'm going to show you another way to send people to a PDF file as well. This system allows you to insert images into the email. So I'm going to, give me on the phone. I'm going to just go up here to this image icon. If I click on image, it's going to say, how do I want the image placed? And this is getting into a little bit of HTML. If you're comfortable with it, you can play around with sizing of the images. You can play around with, do I want left justified, right justified, centered, that kind of thing. But I'm going to go up here just to my file folder. And right now my image file folder is empty. I go down here, if I want to browse my computer, I can browse. And let's, I want to find this small logo, which I think is the Fidelity logo, and I click on upload. So this is just an easy way to put an image into your library, so to speak. But you can put PDFs in here, JPEGs, you can put anything in here that you want. But the great thing about it is when we upload an image, we actually create this URL. We actually create this internet address. So when our emails go out, those emails go out without being attachments, without being links out. They're embedded right into the email. So if I were to go to another website just of this one logo, well, this logo is now on the internet, and that's the URL that's associated with it. So one great thing about it is when you insert the image into your email, you can not only resize it, play with it, but you can also link out to it if you want to. So if you had and you wanted to put a PDF up there, I mean, maybe it's market share information, maybe it's area home sales information, you can put it into your emails and you can link out or you can embed. And this, I'm just showing you, I'm putting a logo into the system this way.
Right, right.
And you just need to play around with how you want it placed. If you want to put a picture into the system, that's all. Type around it, that kind of thing. Those are the things you're probably
now, would that be the place where I upload a PDF like of a marketing piece, or should I at this time just send it to you for now?
Well, there's two ways of doing it. Okay, so here's an example. Let's take that same thought. So if I go over here and I upload a PDF file, I'm just going to go find one real quick. I have a PDF here. 10 Mistakes PDF. I'm not sure what that is. But I've got now my all files. Oops, sorry. 10 Mistakes PDF. Open, upload it. So I've just uploaded this 10 Mistakes PDF. By me uploading that, again, I've got a website URL right here. So if I wanted to copy this URL, I'm going to go out of my library now. And let's say I want to say up here, top 10 mistakes. And if I go highlight here and put a hyperlink to it, just going to show you what this is going to look like. I'm going to paste that URL for the PDF. I'm going to delete the HTTP so I don't replicate it here. I'm going to say 10 mistakes. And insert and OK. So now if somebody clicked on there, they'd see the 10 mistakes. What they would see is when I go to another window, if they clicked on it, they would actually go see this now. And this is the way it would pop up in their browser, 10 mistakes. So I just copied an article, it looks like, on 10 mistakes of email marketing. So, but they'll see it real fast, and they'll see it. So if you have an 8.5 by 11 that you want it to pop up like that so they can print it out as an 8.5 by 11 and distribute it any way they want to, you might do that. If you send it to us to upload in the Marketing Center, what we do is we take that PDF file and we convert it to an HTML image. We want to make sure that when you click on Marketing Center and send out a marketing piece, it pops right up in somebody's email box where they don't have to click on it, go to a link or anything like that.
Right, so, I like that better usually.
Yeah, so we do it both ways. So you've got the flexibility of doing it that way on the campaign side. Lastly, on the campaign side, so you can always go in and change the marketing campaigns that are there. So I'm just going to go pull up the farming campaign. Farming campaign's got 20 emails in it, and I'll see the emails that are here. If I want to change the days, I can. Day one is tomorrow morning. Day zero is the email will go out in 2-hour increments. So day one is tomorrow, day zero, 2-hour increments. So if I started this campaign for somebody, literally, it would go out between 4:01 and 6:01, let's say, for the first email. If I wanted to not send this one and not send this one, you know, I could delete those. I could always change the days up if I wanted to. And I want to go on day 14 and day 28, and you can play around with that, or you can get specific on what day. If you want to edit any of the emails that are there within the standard, you know, farm campaign, you'll see what it is. You can put your own touch in here. You could literally say, okay, insert the person's first name there, because if they see the person, if they see their name, then you know, Scott data can be produced. You know, they'll just read it more. So you can add that personal touch if you want to. That is playing around editing the campaigns. Now, let's say you wanted to go build your own campaign. Let's say, you know, I'm going to put together some of my own nice letters. Maybe they're REO-oriented letters, that kind of thing. Or maybe I have letters already that I want to put into the system. You can start by managing your e-letters. You can look at the 200 letters that are in there, 200 emails that are in there already. Closed order campaign, thank you order campaign, common title insurance questions. And again, just add your own little flair for it in terms of your own personalization, or you just simply say, I'm going to start from scratch. Add e-letter, their upper right-hand corner, lets you start from scratch. I'm just going to call it test so I can delete it easily. Again, anything that you type in the subject line, that's what the client's going to see. They're going to see that message of one. And then you've got your templates, whether it be a blank template, whether it be if you want to send out something to Keller Williams agents and use Keller Williams colors, you can. Totally up to you. Or you say, you know what, I want the Fidelity National Title template, or I want the market update template. If you choose the Fidelity National Title template and click on continue, you're basically starting from scratch. You're basically starting from the empty point where you got a logo. You start typing in your title, whatever you want your title to be. Just remember, when it comes to editing, you've got all, you know, kinds of colors here available to you. If I want red, if I want to put it in a different font, you know, color, I mean font name, you can. You know, so you can pick and choose fonts. Oops, sorry about that. If you want to enlarge it, make it smaller, you can do that. And then you start typing away in terms of what you want your message to be. Again, save your work and then send yourself a test message to make sure it looks right. And it's formatted properly, so you've got it set up to use in the future. Again, you can use mail merge fields. You can insert, you know, your own phone number. Now, whatever you put in the My Personal Configuration screen above, here on the Personal Configuration is the way it's going to read out. So if you put a phone number in and you want the parentheses, just make sure you put the parentheses in Personal Configuration. Just don't put 10 characters all together.
Got it.
So that's just playing around with new letters. So I saved this test letter, so I'm going to delete it. So I just want to show you what I'm doing. By me saving this test letter, I now want to put this test letter in a campaign all by its own. I want to put it into my thank you campaign. Maybe I want to say, if I meet somebody for the very first time, I want them to get this letter. So right now I'm just going to go back to the first part of it. Well, let's just do this. Go back again. If I'm starting at home, and I want to send that test letter out to somebody, I could either go to my contacts, I could put a person into my database, and I'm just going to go pick one person real quick. Click on it. Close these windows. So I could do a couple of things. I've got my letters written, let's say my thank you letter. If I want to send, well, first of all, if you highlight a person that's got an email address, and if you click on this email address, it's going to start your Outlook and send them an email out of your Outlook rather than our system. So okay. It's an easy way of sending emails to them, number one. But if I wanted to send them a standard letter that I just did, I can go over here to the right, this hammer and wrench, and click on send e-letter. If I send the e-letter, you know what? I want to go send the test letter that I just created, test, and then click on submit, and then it's gone, and it's going to go out within that two-hour window period of time. Or if I wanted to go over here to tips, and I wanted to go into the campaign section, marketing campaigns, I can literally say, you know what? I've got my letter in there called test. I want to add a campaign. And you could literally say, nice to meet you. A client. Okay, and you could say, okay, I want the first letter to go out to be the test letter, my thank you letter that I created. I want it to go out now within a two-hour window, or you know what? I want it to go out tomorrow, so on day one. And then you just go pick your letters. Okay? And you can put down whatever time period, however you want to drip on them. And you can start a campaign that way. So every time somebody, instead of sending them just one letter, then you're going to send them a series of letters, you know, over time, once a month, however you want to. Send members letters to stay in contact with that person. Now, that's one way of doing it. So just remember, you've got all the tools available. E-letters and campaigns are in the tip section, tips. Sources is where you can input and track open orders, closed orders, orders by agent, by escrow, by title officer, you name it, you can track it this way. We've purposely kept it simple for you to put in or to actually get into the system. Right now it's a manual way of getting them in. But if you put them in, then you can literally see, did the person give me 10 orders and close 3, or did they give me 10 orders and close 7 kind of thing. So I'm just going to go in and click on Add Order. If I know my order date, great, I'm looking at my take sheet, it happens to be on the 23rd. I put in my order number. I select the agent from the agent catalog, from the agent database. When I imported all the agents, I put in, you know, some of your agents in there already in that database. So just select your agent by the address book. Title officer is how you put them in up here under Add Edit Title Officers. Escrow name, again, is if you put them in as a contact and you select them or as an agent or as the escrow officer group, then they'll appear there and put the address in and simply click on Save. When you save that order, it will ask you, do you want to put out a thank you letter for that one order, or do you want to start them on a thank you campaign? So when you look in the campaigns and see the thank you campaign and the closed order campaign, that's what they're for. You literally can mail merge into those emails. Your title officer is this. Your title number is this. So it allows you to stay in contact with them throughout the transaction. And once you start getting orders in and you want to start playing around with reports and seeing how it looks and feels, then I can help you with that a little bit. But what I would do right now, for now, to get you started is a couple of assignments. Number one, log in. I'll send you a username and password. Log in, go to My Profile, update your password if you want to, and update this information. I'll fix your photo here for your team photo. Update this information and put your zip codes in. Then that will allow me to put more information in there. The next thing I want you to do is I want you to go to tips, and within tips, immediately go to the top, personal configuration, and update this information. So all your e-letters and e-campaigns that go out that are using the personal configuration mail merge fields, you've got those all set up. Photo, logo, I'll go in and do that right after we get off the phone call. And then just start playing around with e-letters, e-campaigns, if you need help or assistance.
Yeah, I was using Blue Hornet before.
I'm not familiar with Blue Hornet.
It's an email system, but it's so hard to, like, make them look good. I, you know, I'd have to cut and paste, and because it was too big to put in, and this and that, and that's where I got all those email addresses were ones that we've over the years gotten.
Right.
And that's the system we were using.
Okay. Well, if you haven't,
but this just seems like so much easier.
Well, it is. I mean, you know, it can get as complicated as you want to as well. I mean,
right.
Give you another helpful hint on the tip side. When you get into marketing campaigns and you're starting to do stuff on the HTML side,
mm-hmm.
let's just look up a letter, you know, checking disk space. When you're playing around with letters, okay, I mean, you'll notice that, you know, these are coming in tables in terms of the different layouts. When you're starting to get an HTML, and you can always go into the HTML, you know, editing mode. Or what I tell people to do is, you know, if you have front page, or if you have Dreamweaver, and if you know the exact layout that you want, if you can create an HTML piece, you can copy it right out of Dreamweaver or front page and copy it right into here. Just copy and paste,
right?
To save yourself some time. So it can get as complicated as you want
it's
to.
It's technical,
but,
yeah, and yeah.
But you've got the tools to do it with all the editing mode up here. So,
cool.
But if you need help, let me know.
I definitely will. I'm very excited.
Yeah, just get to a place where you say, okay, I'm going to start simple. I'm gonna choose to put certain. Maybe I want to put an email out to everybody, and say, you know, happy first quarter or whatever it may be. You know,
actually, what I think I might like to do is put out. I'm updating my database. Please send me your current contact information and birthday information.
Yeah, that'd be perfect. So when you do that, then when you get bounces, you'll get them immediately.
Perfect.
And then
I manage that. I go in and take those out?
Exactly. Or you just change, if they update the information, you just change that. Again, we're not going to see those.
Okay.
But if they click on remove, if an email gets removed, then we'll manage that for you automatically. So you don't have to worry about that. And then say, what kind of campaign letters do I want to write for my REO agents? And do I want to send them a once a month thing? Or what do I want to write for a nice to meet you letter? Or what do I want to write for when I meet a brand new real estate agent? How often do I want to communicate with them? If you look down here at the solutions campaign, the solutions marketing campaign, some people have started real simple and said, you know what, common title insurance questions. What is a preliminary report? Just you might want to put somebody like this on a every 2-week emailing. If you want to change the header or footer, you can. But look at some of these and say, you know what, I don't want to say that. I want to change a word or two. Feel free to go ahead and change words. Once you change it, it becomes yours. Now, the last thing I'll share with you is at some point in time, you know, some people may say, you know, gosh, you know, I really would like to share this with another title rep. You go through all this effort and time, you know, maybe, hey, if I want to push this campaign to somebody else, that's what we call it. If you open the campaign, you literally can go over here to the right-hand side and push the campaign to somebody. You can say, you know what, I'll share it with you. You know, this system, your data, your letters, your contacts, everything is completely 100% confidential to you unless you want to give people access to it, meaning I want somebody to get that campaign that I created so they don't have to start from scratch. And you could do that if you wanted to. They'll never see your contacts. That will always be confidential to you in terms of that. And then,
but they have to be on the system to do that.
Exactly.
Gotcha.
You know, you might want to put yourself on a regular tickler file, remind yourself, put it on the calendar or something. You might want to just, you know, to export the clients, you know, every 3 months, something like that yourself. We back up the clients weekly, but, you know, you might want to just have a, you know, it's a simple CSV file, so you might, you know, want to do that yourself.
But absolutely.
Any questions, just let me know. Just email me, and I'm here to help you. I want to make sure you're productive with it.
Excellent, excellent. I'm going to get on this as soon as you send me my login and password.
Okay, I'll do it right now.
Cool.
Okay, enjoy.
Thanks so much.
Okay, you're welcome.
Okay.
Bye.
Bye-bye.